Hello, good evening, and welcome to Ali Ahmed Khan Hospital. And this is your host, Dr. Imjad Hussain. And today I'm going to talk about PPE and the way to wear it and the way to remove it and discard it. So we'll start first with the introduction of PPE. What is PPE? PPE is personal protective equipment. And as the name says it all, it's used to protect people. It's used to protect workers, and especially in the face of this COVID-19 disease, it's used to protect healthcare providers, including nurses, staff members, and all other people who are involved in patient caregiving. So personal protective equipment is a set of it's a set of not instrument, but it's a set of things like mask, gown, and it's your face shield, actually your goggles, and it could also be something that puts a barrier between you and patient. So basically that's the purpose of PPE, and it's used in some standard condition or some infectious condition where we need to put a barrier between patient and ourselves. So PPE basically works in two ways. In a way, it protects healthcare provider or someone who's wearing it from infecting other peoples. Like, for example, if some healthcare provider has a disease and he might be infecting it through respiratory droplets to other people, to his patients or rest of the colleagues. So it acts as a barrier between the two. And the other way is it also puts a barrier between patient and healthcare provider. Like if a patient is coughing and we give him a mask, so that's the way we put a physical barrier between the healthcare provider, or in case could be his caregiver, his family members, and between himself or herself. So it puts a barrier between patient and caregiver or healthcare provider too. It works both ways. So what are the types of PPE that we usually use in terms of infection prevention control, IPC measures? WHO usually is the one who comes up with recommendation and guideline, but there are other institutions also, like Center for Disease Control, CDC, and local interest groups or hospital. They devise guidelines according to their needs and circumstances. So there are basically three types of precautions regarding this disease, COVID-19, because we are talking with the context of COVID-19, PPE's usage in terms of COVID-19. So in terms of contact precautions, we require a gown and a glove. And for droplet precautions, we require a surgical mask. And we have to be within at least 3 to 6 feet of the patient. It works that way. And for airborne precautions, first of all, we have to use these type of masks that are specially designed to keep people safe from airborne infections. For example, it's like a N95 mask or N95 respirator is what that is required in airborne precautions. And then we also need negative pressure isolation rooms to be able to deal with the risk of airborne infectious agents. So it's not just the N95 mask, but there are also sort of masks that are being used to curtail the spread of this this scourge. Another one is FFP2 mask. They have also been used. And then there are other types of masks too that have different numbers And basically, these are designated by OSHA, Occupational Safety and Health Hazard Association. And the National Testing Laboratories, they do standardized testing for these masks and other PPE to find if they are truly able to do what they are designed to do. So a PPE has to be a standardized PPE, because a substandard PPE would be giving you false security. And in terms of N95 mask, I will add further that N95 masks are for airborne precaution, so they must be worn out only during procedure that generate aerosolization. And especially with this virus, as we are knowing a lot about this virus that was previously unknown, and there is plethora of evidence and there is plethora of data that we have to process each and every day. So we have some new details too, that this virus has a potential to be airborne, because in some studies it has been shown that it was not just the size of the virion or size of the particle that mattered, because in conditions like sneezing and coughing, patient generates a turbulent cloud of particles, mucosalivary particles that are of different sizes, and they travel according to the size of these particulate matters, and the heavier ones fall closer ones, so they stick to the surfaces and they carry the risk of spread of disease through fomites. And particles that are smaller than that, they do suspend or stay in air for a while, or so it has been seen that some of the virion particles, or we call that the smallest or minuscule of the particles, has nuclei, so they could remain suspended in the air for a while, and especially under conditions or under rooms that are not really ventilated, for example aircrafts and others, it could be a major source of spread, airborne spread. Airborne could be a major risk to spread of disease. So it's very important to stay away from. It's now said that 2 meters is enough, but according to some new studies, it's not a safe distance anymore. It's a lot less. WHO claimed it to be 1 meter, and CDC came out with the idea of putting people at a distance of 2 meters, but from other studies, other scientific evidence, the virus seems to travel a lot longer distances than it was previously supposed. So even it said like the virus from a sneeze, it could stay in air or go as far as up to 10 or 15 feet, so it could be like 4 or 5 meters even, it's claimed to be the travel distance of a turbulent cloud of sneeze. So we'll move further with the PPE. So let's see how many types of PPE we use and what should be the order of wearing a PPE. And that's what we know as donning a PPE. It's the way how we put it. So there has to be a certain way. First of all, we start with the gown. In terms of sequential order, we first put on the gown, then we put on the mask or the respirator that we have. And the next one on the list is we put goggle or the face shields, and gloves come last of all. So we'll talk about donning off or doffing off or removing off the PPE later, but let's see how we should wear a gown first. So this gown, basically it's not the one that is used in surgeries, so it does not have to be irradiated or really sterilized in a way, but most of these they come gamma rays irradiated, but they could not have been. So the main essence or the main thing of wearing a gown is to also put a barrier between patient and yourself, and especially protecting your clothes from mucosalivary particles. So using a gown, you have to basically do it in a way that it fully covers your torso, and it's from your neck to the knees, so it should be at least that much lengthy, and it should cover your arm length and up to the end of your waist. It should also cover, and there should also be a wraparound thing around your back, like where you can fasten the knot or the ties at the back of your neck or either at your waist. So that's the way to wear a gown. And then we move on to the next PPE in our sequence of order, in our order of sequence. So we use a face mask, and face masks are mostly the medical or surgical mask that is being used mostly. And the way to do it is you have to secure the knots at the back of your head or at the neck, and while minimally touching the inside of the mask, and you have to keep the colored part, or the it's mostly said that in a way it's different in texture from the inner side of the face mask. So the outer layer has to be hydrophobic in a way, and it looks a bit shiny if you see if you compare both inside and outside of the mask. So the outer hydrophobic portion has to be colored, but since there is shortage of masks and supplies, so I'm not sure that people would be getting colored part or the lighter part. So but the right way to do is it a standardized mask has to be colored part should be out, because that's the way it's supposed to protect you actually from infecting other people. That's the main purpose or essence of it. So and then you have to make it fit according to the contours of your face. So usually there is a metal part or something like a thin wire woven inside the upper edge of the mask, and you have to adjust that on the nose of on the bridge of your nose, and so that it makes kind of a seal around your face. And then you also pull down the lower part, the lower edge of the mask to adjust and cover your chin, so it should make a snugly fit. So that's the purpose of using a face mask. And for respirators, it's a bit difficult. Respirators are supposed to be well fitted. That's the main purpose of using a respirator or N95 mask. And usually before donning an N95 mask, people are required to have a fit test. And for finding the true size of an N95 mask, it's called a fit test. It's a like a series of tests and assessment that is performed by a trained evaluator, and the goal is to make a tight seal on the healthcare provider face. Otherwise it's not going to be useful for the purpose it's intended to be. And the third part is putting on a face shield or a goggle, and that's the it's not that difficult. The main rule of wearing a PPE or donning a PPE is to not to touch the inner part of your PPE, because if you are already infected, then or you're carrying a virus from surfaces, you can already infect your personal protective equipment. And so the first thing that comes to mind for wearing a PPE or donning a PPE is you have to first wash your hand with soap water, or use a 70% alcohol swab or 70% alcohol spray, and then you start wearing your PPE. So for wearing goggles, it's not that difficult, and face mask, it's kind of one in same way. You secure it with one hand on the front of your face or eyes, and with the other hand you just pull the band on the back of your head, mostly it's stretchable, so that's how you do it. And the fourth thing is wearing a surgical glove. So this glove is an ordinary glove. Actually, it's not surgical glove, the one we use for surgery. So basically they are not sterilized. These are non-sterilized gloves, but they should be well fitting. They should not be loose, the plastic kind of, or the clear transparent gloves are not that good to be used, but they are disposable gloves. So what you do is you pull one glove from the outer surface without touching the inside of glove, and you pull it onto one hand, and then once you have worn it on one hand, then you can do it in the same way without touching the inside of the glove, and you have to pull it up to your wrists actually. So you should be covering the ends of your gowns with it. That's the proper way to do it, and then you're all set to go. You are ready, you have worn your PPE, and now we move on to removing your PPE. But let me just revise the sequence again for putting on a PPE. So first we do with the gown, and then we put on a mask or respirator on second, and third thing we do is put a goggle or face shield, and fourth one we do is use the disposable gloves. So that's the last of it. And removing or the doffing a PPE would be a different sequence, or then would be a different order to it. And there are kind of two options or two ways to do it. There could be many ways, but at least there are two ways, and the sequence will be different. So what we did last of all, we would be doing first of all. So the last thing we did was to wear a glove, and in terms of removing a glove, in terms of removing PPE, we'll do the first thing we remove will be the glove. So we take off the glove in a way that we are not again touching the inside of the glove. So with one hand we pull off the glove from the outer surface of it, and when it's kind of plucked, then we just using the edge of our finger we kind of sneak into the inside edge of other glove, and we just pull through the other hand, and insert in a way that the first glove that we were taking off that goes in between the other glove. So that's the way to remove gloves, and then we do with the face shields and goggles. And again we take care of not touching the insides of these PPE, because once we have touched these worn out or used PPE from the outside, we are supposed to be carrying infective particles on it. So we should not be touching inside, and if somehow inadvertently by mistake we touch the inside of it, then we have to wash our hands and then start removing our PPE. So we take our face shields and goggles in a way that outside of our PPE is not being touched to our body parts. So we remove it in taking care of the outer side of our PPE. So now we come to the gown, and in terms of removing gown, we can simply untie it with our hand from the back, and then just simply walk out of it. And again, in a similar way that we are keeping our inside in touch with the inside of the gown, and we do not touch the outer part of our gown, because outer part is supposed to be carrying infection, as we said before. And now we have removed gloves, goggles, gowns, and so the last of all will be doing away with our respirator or the face mask. So we'll do it last of all. So this is, there is a main difference in sequence of things in removing PPE, and we see that the face mask comes at the last of all. So the other way or other option of removing PPE is that we remove two kind of personal protective equipment together. So how we do it? First of all, we can remove gloves and gown together in a way. When we are pulling off with our glove and we are pulling off with our gown and we are wearing gloves in a fashion that it's covering the edges of our gloves, so we kind of pull through the whole thing in one piece and we kind of directly discard it in a secure place or infectious waste bin, and making it in a sort of just rounding it. And then after removing glove and gown, we do away with the goggle and face shield in similar fashion we did before. And again, the last of all, we do away with our face mask or respirators. So what we should do again after donning or doffing with our PPE, we have to wash our hands again with soap water or with sanitizer, 70% isopropyl alcohol. So I hope this will serve as a guide to most of us. It's not very difficult. These are simple steps, but they make a huge difference in terms of spread of infections and in terms of fighting this pestilence. So thank you very much. Take care. Good night.